My next guest has had 5 top 10 hits and, would you believe, 10 billion, yes, billion, streams online. Anne-Marie joins me now. It is so good to see you.
Me too.
And it's kind of like happy birthday as well.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm loving the pink, Anne-Marie.
I know, it's
I'm
perfect.
Loving the pink. You're so on message, because that's what we're doing in our fashion shoot. See, this isn't just flung together yet. But yeah, you're having lots of little birthday parties.
Yeah, I'm throwing loads of birthday parties around in the cities and different countries. So we basically just thought, instead of just going places and doing like normal, boring signing and having one picture with your fans, I just felt like I really wanted to spend an evening with them and actually party with them. So we're like hiring out different venues around the world, like bowling, karaoke, just having a party with them.
This is brilliant.
I know.
This is the way forward.
I'm going to have a lot of fun.
I think it'll be great. And you have got such loyal fans. I mean, when people knew you were coming in today, we got inundated on the social media, because people, but it's your attitude as well towards people. You're very open and very warm.
Yeah.
Which is great.
I think I guess that's just the way I am. I just love being open with people and letting them in to know who I am. I don't want to just be this person who's an artist and then you don't really know who she is. Is she nice? Is she?
Right.
So I just try and be honest as possible. And I do have that relationship with them. It's like they're my friends. And
very much so. I think that's great. And you've been very open about things like you've had anxiety. Mm-hmm. So many people suffer from that.
Yes.
I'm glad not so much in silence. You know, people are talking about it now. And you had this brilliant hashtag thing about the 15 minutes, which was really good.
Yeah. So my first album was called Speak Your Mind.
Of course.
And I come up with this hashtag on Twitter called Speak Your Mind in 15 Minutes.
Right.
And I just thought, on a Sunday, the day before the week starts, just let out how you're feeling, whether it is good things or bad things, but they had 15 minutes to do it. So they just had 15 minutes at 3 p.m. to get everything off their chest, and I just thought, right, now I'll leave that, let that be, and now move forward into the week and see if it helps. And they were saying that it helped them for the week. And
do you know, it's a really good idea, because we don't do that sometimes. We don't just actually sit down 5 minutes, well, 15 minutes, and see what's bothering us or what we've got to celebrate, because actually that's really good too.
Yeah.
Because sometimes you're feeling a bit, you know, a bit sort of like not sure and a bit meh, and then you think, but actually I've got this to be thankful for, and then you make a wee list and you think, hey, life's all right.
Exactly. I think because I'm so lucky, I get to write it in songs, so I'm always constantly reminding myself about things I need to think about or talk about, or the success, or when I feel great, I have the chance to write it down on a piece of paper. But I guess it's, people need to say it.
Yeah, no, they do. Do you find, because you know you're a karate expert, do you find that that helps you, like with just overcoming? You know, sometimes we've all got days where we feel, you know, awful. I mean, what helps me is I go to exercise class and work out to your songs, which you must come and see.
Yes.
But you know, that makes me feel better. Mm. But for you, does the whole kind of karate thing make you feel better?
Karate is a massive part of my life. I think if I didn't train in karate, I wouldn't be this person. Honestly,
I'd
be a totally different person.
Gosh,
I think it taught me so much about confidence. About,
we're just joking about him.
I was trying
but
to be serious.
Good. Yes, you have many celebrity pupils, shall we say. You are the master and they are the pupils. Look at Ollie. Oh, there's Scott. There's
Scott.
And Scott himself, he suffered from anxiety. Mm-hmm. He's talked about it a lot.
Yeah.
Do you feel really empowered when you're doing karate? You just feel like, well, I'm a strong woman.
Yes.
I can do anything.
I totally feel like that. And that's why when you first become an artist and they go, what do you want to call your fans? And I was like, I don't know what, because people rhyme it with their name. And I was like, what rhymes with Anne-Marie? And then I just thought, do you know what? When I'm doing karate, I feel so strong and I feel like I can overcome anything. So I basically call them my ninjas, because hope that they feel like strong when they call themselves that.
So what I really love about artists like yourself is that it's so much more, of course the music is the most important thing, of course it is, but it's so much more than that. And I think that's where, you know, social media gets a kicking, sometimes quite rightly, but actually this is where it can be so good.
Yeah.
And it's where you can actually get a big message out there.
Absolutely.
It's important.
I mean, I try and put messages into my music so like that can reach a certain amount of people, but I just think if you have the platform on social media, why not use it to your advantage and speak about things that need to be spoken about? I just think it's so important.
No, absolutely. And the thing about you as well, you're a grafter.
Yeah.
You have to be, don't you? I mean, you can't, success is, you know, people say, oh, we're very, very lucky. And it's amazing that lucky people are the most hardworking people in the world. But you do have to, I mean, you clearly love what you do.
Yeah.
You know, you can see that. You can see that. You come alive when you're talking about music and karate. Yeah. But you do have to work at it. You know, it's that you can't take it for granted, can you?
No, I look at people like Ed Sheeran and Elton John and people like that, and they always used to tell me, like, you can't just give up on the first hurdle. And that's the same with everything in life. Same with karate.
Yes.
I guess when you get punched in the face, you can't really just stop.
No, you've got to keep going, that's
true. You have
to
keep going, and I think that's the same in music industry. You can't just think that your first success is going to keep you going forever.
Yeah.
You have to keep working and write better songs every day. And that's what I try and do.
And you get better and better and better. I mean, look at Elton John. Elton John is in his prime.
Yes.
And he's like this, what I love about him, he's like this agony uncle. You know, you mentioned he's given you advice.
Yeah.
Ed Sheeran has given you advice as well. And what I love about both of them is that they pass it forward.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they've learned all this, particularly Elton John, of course, who's been here forever.
Yeah.
They've learned all of this and they want to make sure that, I mean, he's brilliant at that, a sporting artist. And he phones them up.
Yeah.
He says, here, let me tell you this. Yeah, which is great.
He did phone me once and I said, love you, at the end of the conversation by accident, because I just...
You're allowed.
Like, love you. That was Elton John.
But he's still got this passion for what he does. I mean, he won an Oscar.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he won an Oscar. And you could see in his little face, he was like, oh, my God.
Aww.
And you'd expect someone like that to kind of go, oh, yeah, it's another award, whatever. But he still's got that passion, same as you.
But I love that he is also goes way beyond the music, the stuff that he helps, the charities that he's involved with.
He's millions, hasn't he, for AIDS Foundation?
This is what I'm saying. I just think if you have that platform, you have to, I'm going to be that type of person, I think. I just don't think my life stops at music. I think that I'll try and help people further than that.
Good for you. Yeah. That's really good. I can see you maybe in 20 years' time phoning up, you know, an 18-year-old aspiring Anne-Marie and saying, let me tell you.
Go on the line.
Oh, it's so good to see you. Thank you so much
you
for coming in. And the new single, Birthday, is out right now.
Yes.
And then you're getting prepared for all the birthday parties.
Birthday parties.
Of cake, Anne-Marie.
Loads of
cake. There'll be lots of blowing out of candles and lots of cake.
Lots of oversized T-shirts coming in.
Absolutely. But you work it all off with your karate.
Yeah.
So it keeps you so fit. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Great to see you.
Me too.